Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to create editable text with a long solid shadow in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. Okay, I'm here in Adobe Illustrator. I'll go to New File, Print, Letter, and Create. Then I'll hit T to get on my text tool. I'll click once on my canvas. You don't want to draw a text box for this. I'm just going to type awesome. I'm going to make this quite a bit bigger. And I'm going to use the streetwear font, which is this one. And you can just do a Google search for the streetwear font. It's free for commercial use. Next, I'm going to go to Window Appearance to get my appearance panel up. Right now, my text is in the Characters panel, and I want it in my Type panel, so I'll click the fill here and just delete it. Then I'll click on Type. I'll come up to the hamburger menu here and choose Add New Fill. So now it's in the Type section, and I think I'll just make this yellow. I'll click on my stroke and add a black stroke to this, and as you can see, it's got some weird overlap things going on, so I'm going to click over here in the space beside the stroke and just drag that underneath the fill. And then I'm going to increase the stroke. Oh, that looks pretty good right there. Now I'm going to hold Option or Alt and click and drag my fill until you see this little fist with a plus sign, and that will duplicate it. I'll click on that fill, and I'm going to make the fill black. Next, I'll go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and Transform. First, I'm going to make sure Preview is checked down here. And then I'll change the horizontal and vertical to a small amount. I'm going to put each of them at 1 point. For the copies, I'll highlight what's in there, which is 0. And then I'll hold Shift and use the up arrow. And you can see what's happening. So the more copies you have, the longer the shadow is. Okay, so I'll say okay. Now I'll zoom in and look at the quality of our line here. Now it is kind of bumpy. I don't know if you can see that. And that's because of the values we put in horizontal and vertical move. You can also see down here that we have some stair step going on, and that is not the greatest. I'm going to click on my word to select it, and I'll click on that transform effect. I'm going to change my horizontal to 0.1, and then I'll change my vertical to 0.12. This will also change the appearance, so we're going to have to increase the copies by quite a bit. Okay, this looks pretty good. I've got it at 430 copies. Now, the more copies you have, if you have an older computer, it might slow it down a little bit. So that's something to think about. Okay, we'll say okay. And now I'll zoom in to see what we have. We're looking pretty good here, and we're looking good here too. Okay, I'll zoom out, and now you can see here that it doesn't line up with our stroke, and that's because we didn't apply the transform to our stroke too. I'm going to click on that stroke, and first I'm going to round the corners. So now we have the rounded effect. Then I'll hold Option or Alt, and then click and drag over here to the side to get that little fist and put it on the stroke. So now the transform is applied to our fill, and that same exact transform is applied to our stroke. And now it aligns with the stroke the way it should. Now the nice thing about this is you can change this text. So you can just type whatever you want in here and it's still editable. You can also save this appearance as a graphic style. So I will open up my graphic styles panel. That's also under window if you need it. I'll click and drag right on this little icon beside type in appearance. It's kind of a little preview of what you're going to get. And now we have a new graphic style in our panel. I'll hit T on my keyboard, and then I'll click once to make a new type path. And I'll choose a different font this time. I'm choosing Antonio. I'm going to make it about the same size because your graphic style is based on the size of this, so you want whatever text you're going to make to be about the same size. So I'll click on my text, and then I'll apply this graphic style. And this is the effect we get. And then if we save and close this, this graphic style will stay in here because it's still applied to these. So this will live in the document and it'll be there the next time you open it. And that's it. It's that easy to create editable text where you can change it at any time and also have a cool long shadow effect on it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.